So cool. Well, let me ask then the most obvious starter question to a creating progressive web app stream, which is, what is a progressive web app?
That is an excellent question. So a progressive web app is a web app that uses open standards and APIs to build an experience that does two things. Essentially, at the core, it's still a web app, but it can be installed and used with an experience that is very native-like. And I'm going to start saying platform-specific rather than native, but it can perform like a native app because of the way it's structured. What does that mean for you? That means that you can write an app using the web technologies you're already familiar with and potentially have people download and use it across different device platforms. Now, I will say that having come from the mobile space, my introduction to this came through mobile. It was like, oh, I can write a web app and then I can add it to my home screen on mobile. And now it just looks and feels like it's something I installed from the store, right? From the Android store. And that's what the kind of that was the intent. But what really excited me more recently is you kind of look at it and go, wait, there are other app stores on desktop too. So Windows 11 was the big announcement that I think really spurred me to come do this. So it's not just about an app that you can run on your phone, but you can find it and discover it and use it on your desktop and in any device that has a compliant modern browser. So the way I think about it, it's like the holy grail for multi-platform. It's like one code base. People can use it anywhere as long as they support modern web platforms and APIs.
Okay, very cool. I actually I use Outlook Web Access as a PWA. So I actually don't use Outlook itself. I actually use Oa, and I actually have that installed as a PWA. And it's very interesting to hear you mention that you get a very similar desktop experience to like having it installed. Because one thing that I noticed relatively recently, as far as an update goes, is that I could now associate mail links with the PWA for Oa, which is fantastic. So now if I'm like, browsing or doing whatever, I click on a mail to hyperlink, and it will actually now open that up inside of my installed progressive web app for Outlook Web Access.
Yes, and I think that hopefully we'll get a chance to go kind of look at some of the Project Foo and web capabilities and all. But I think that is also one of the bigger exciting areas that we can look at in progressive web apps, which is the ability for us to do things across that installed PWA and potentially native apps on that platform that were built for that platform. So if I can like share, if I'm doing something in my progressive web apps, I can like share a photo that I can then kind of pull up a different app, like a Twitter native app, and then kind of, use it there. That really removes that friction, right? Like that's when you really start thinking of it as, oh, this is not a browser. So the bigger story, I think, was when you first think about web apps, the earliest progressive web apps I used to use is it was all about don't see the Chrome. It should look and feel like a native app, and that means you don't see any of the Chrome. But I think now it's really about the capabilities. It's like I can do anything you can do on a native app, and it'll behave alongside those. So yeah, I love that. I should have actually added, I think Teams and Outlook too, should have added them as good examples for PWAs. We should go rate them and see.
There you go. There you go. Now, you mentioned a series of like open standards, and you mentioned being able to have one code base and have that run everywhere. And I think that that raises a big question, which is, if I'm a web developer and maybe like today I'm not thinking, oh, we're going to do a PWA, but we might want to do this in the future, do I have to
Yes.
change the way that I do my development if I'm going to be eventually turning my web app into a PWA?
It depends. So I'm going to put on my app developer versus web app developer because I also want to be very friendly to the mobile folks and say you can do this too. But I don't know how you guessed that when I was scrolling through this, there would be an answer in here somewhere. I'm going to throw this out and say I'm starting a blog that I'm going to track my learning journey and put resources, so definitely check it out. But this is a if you can see my screen and you see this kind of the grid, like do you see this picture which says native PWA and web apps? That's kind of the one that I'm a very visual person. If I can kind of visualize how these things fall into any space that helps me, this is the one that's on the web dev, like what are PWAs canonical article that I really like. And so what I'm going to look at this and say is, if you're a web app developer, and this is literally what I'd written in the blog post itself. If you're a web app developer, you're in that orange spot, right? If you're a native app developer, you're in the blue spot, and PWAs are in the pink spot. What does that mean? If you're a web app developer, you're already closer to PWAs than you know, because you know intrinsically the technologies that you're going to use to build a web app that will run on modern browser platforms. All you then need to do is to check off the three kind of requirements or capabilities that that are needed to convert your existing web app into a PWA. We'll talk a little bit about that, and maybe I'll kind of share some links as well. The reason I bring this up is that it's probably easier for you because chances are you use one of the standard frameworks. Maybe you come from Vue, maybe you use React, or maybe you use Angular. And almost all of the modern frameworks have a path for PWA, meaning that they'll have an example of how you can take that existing app and tailor it. And we should talk about PWA Builder, because you can literally point it to an app and it'll tell you it'll give you recommendations of what you can fix to make your app kind of work well. That said, your choices are as follows. Do you want to take an existing web app and migrate it? Or do you want to build a new app from scratch? And what should you do? That, I think, is a bigger question. And the way I was beginning to look at it is, it depends on what you're trying to do. Who is your audience? If you're building an app that is primarily web-driven, like all the stuff that you're going to do doesn't really require or need a native launched experience, stick with your web app until you realize, hey, this could expand my audience to a desktop or mobile and then go there. Don't have to just migrate it. Don't build from scratch. But if you're trying to kind of realize a new idea, I would say start from PWAs and see whether you can build it incrementally. The big challenge, I think, is really in the capabilities. If you end up using a native capability that's not available in web apps, coming from a mobile app to PWAs is harder. Mm-hmm. But from web apps, yeah. The migration, there are actually patterns, by the way, that tell you how to iteratively move from, just by moving one feature, or just by kind of getting an offline page, right? Those kinds of things that you can try before you get and kind of jump wholeheartedly into redoing your entire app.